Like we receive a medical team in the future if an outbreak occurs. Why is it that the world has to rely on China to lead us? I thought America was supposed to be great. I thought America was supposed to be exceptional. And instead of leading us on the response to this virus, they're bumbling it. They're making everything worse. And their incompetence is causing panic in our communities. In Venezuela, the sanctions having killed. Last year, we learned that the sanctions had already killed 40,000 people. But last week, the former UN Special Rapporteur, Alfred Zelaya, updated that number. The sanctions in Venezuela have now killed 100,000 people. It's mass murder through economic warfare. It's collective punishment on civilians, whether it's in Iran, in Venezuela, in Cuba, or in North Korea, or any of the 30 countries sanctioned by the United States. Sanctions need to be lifted everywhere, especially right now that we're facing a global pandemic because of the coronavirus. Lift the sanctions now!
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 So the question is, how are we going to come together as a world community to fight this terrible disease that is plaguing people around the globe? That we can't fight this alone. We know that it keeps spreading. And we know that countries need resources to be able to fight this. Iran just has seen in the last 2 years its economy decimated. It does not have the financial resources it needs to fight this pandemic. It does not have the vigorous healthcare system that it once had. It does not have the ability to do all the testing it needs to do and then to take care of all the people who need to be taken care of. So we are here to say that the best thing that the U.S. can do is to use this opportunity when the world community is fighting this disease to say, we are going to be part of the solution. We're going to lift the sanctions. We're going to allow Iran to sell its oil on the international market so that it would have the resources to fight this disease. We're going to join the world community and stop punishing governments by strangling their economies, whether it's Iran or Venezuela or Cuba or North Korea. Now is the time that countries need resources to help their people. So here we are in front of the Treasury Department, and it is the Treasury Department that is charged with enacting these sanctions. It's through the Treasury Department that the heavy hand of the United States is put on companies, not only in the U.S., but companies around the world, to tell them not to trade with Iran, to tell them not to trade with Venezuela, to tell them not to trade with Cuba, to tell them it is illegal to trade with North Korea. And so that's why we're here in front of the Treasury Department. And we have sent them thousands of signatures from people all over the country who have signed a petition saying, in the name of humanity, in the name of a global fight against the terrible disease that is taking the lives of people all over the world every single day, please lift the sanctions, allow Iran to breathe economically so that it can help its people breathe literally. So this is a time for the heart and hearts of this government to be softened. realize that there are moments in our history when there are plagues that affect the entire globe, and that people have to come together to find vaccines, to treat the people who are infected, to find ways to stop the spread. We should be working closely with the Iranian government right now, but the foreign minister is not even allowed in this country except sometimes to go to the United Nations. But even then, he is not guaranteed a visa. When all kinds of people in the Iranian government have been sanctioned, this is the time to reverse those policies. So that's why we're here, that's why we've sent thousands of signatures to the Treasury Department. And that's why we'll keep educating people about the need to push our government to say that sanctions kill on a regular basis. We've seen studies showing in Venezuela. First, we saw studies showing that 40,000 people, and now we have a UN representative, a former UN representative, saying that it's more like 100,000 people who have been killed by the sanctions in Venezuela. And we have the president of Venezuela saying it's just a matter of time before there is coronavirus there. And the healthcare system there has been decimated by the sanctions. So we need to find a policy that gives countries all the resources they can muster up to fight this. And we're doing just the opposite. We're taking those resources away. So if there was ever a time for the American people to come together and say, stop this brutal policy of economic warfare, economic terrorism, medical terrorism, it is right now. So let's say together, lift the sanctions now.
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 Lift the sanctions now. Lift the sanctions now.
Lift the sanctions now.
Lift the sanctions now.
So we are going to mark up the Treasury Department as the dangerous entity that it is. The Treasury Department has caused untold deaths across the world with its policies of sanctions. And this is just the beginning of this global pandemic. We don't know how many cases of coronavirus there are in the United States. We don't know how many will die in the United States from this pandemic. Iran, once they were able to, took the testing kit from the World Health Organization to find out what if their population had coronavirus so that they could do everything in their power to treat them. They might have acted a little bit too late, but they did take the World Health Organization testing. Guess who refused the testing kits from the World Health Organization? Donald Trump. He said, no way, we don't want testing kits from the United Nations. From the World Health Organization. He refused them and said, we're going to use only our own. Well, the American test kits didn't work. Continues to say that there are plenty of testing kits in the United States, plenty of tests and people can get tested, but actually they can't. They cannot get tested.
What are you trying to do here, Medea?
So we're trying to show that this is a danger zone because the Treasury Department is putting the lives of millions of people at danger because of the sanctions. And when they are cutting off the resources, the countries need to fight. Then this is a dangerous situation. People's lives are in the balance. People are dying every day already from this disease. But by keeping the resources from countries like Iran that they need for their healthcare system, we are literally killing people every day. Because it's the Treasury Department.
Lift the sanctions now! Lift the sanctions now!
I'll be right back. Let me see what the...
Lift the sanctions now!
Lift the sanctions now! Lift the sanctions now! Lift the sanctions now! Lift the sanctions now!
My apologies. Always good to do some cop watching. What should the United States be doing? I saw that actually the WHO, since you've been here, declared that this is now a global pandemic. What should U.S. involvement in this issue look like? All right, thank you, I appreciate it.
Stop the sanctions now! End the pandemic! Stop
sanctions.
So you can go to codepink.org/Iran, and you will see at the top of the page an action that you can take to add your name to our letter to the Treasury Department, telling them that these sanctions are criminal and are costing lives. You can add your name to our letter to the Treasury Department, demanding that they lift the sanctions on Iran. Immediately, all sanctions related to medicine must be lifted on Iran, and then all sanctions entirely must be lifted on Iran, on Venezuela, the embargo on Cuba. We have had enough of this. So you go to codepink.org/Iran.
Sanctions are a form of war.
In the sanctions, we shall not be moved. terrorismo impedir que un país en situación de pandemia como la presente sobre el riesgo de salud.
Keep doing everything you can to end the sanctions. Restore humanity.
Hmm? Yeah. I'm happy to take them too. Yeah. Yeah, do you have a phone? Ariel, before you wrap up, do you mind doing a quick interview with me as well? I'd love for you to just give me a quick summary of what the issue was here and what kind of the urgency of it is. I see that WHO calls this now a global pandemic. All right, thank you, Arielle. I appreciate it. All right, that's a wrap. In case anybody didn't see, Washington, D.C. Issued an advisory, not an order, but an advisory saying that they don't want people to have gatherings in excess of 1,000 people anymore here in D.C. So obviously this was a smaller demonstration than that by a long shot, but in general, this issue is definitely spreading, and it's spreading fast. And they're drawing attention to a sort of specific issue, which is how U.S. sanctions impact some other nations, in particular Iran, as it relates to coronavirus. So with that, like, share, subscribe, leave your ideas in the comments. What do you think of their demonstration, both the tactics and the visuals of it, as well as what they had to say? And I'll also leave the Patreon link in the comments there if you'd like to chip in a few bucks for me to be able to continue doing this work. Thank you for watching.